Okay, here we go. Here's another way to make gold with minimal effort. As you can see, I have multiple tunes here. I go in, and this really just takes maybe 10, 15 minutes a day. You can do it once a day, twice a day. It's using your Garrison followers. I have my, as you can see, I have zero gold right now. I'm gonna go into these here. Three completed missions, naval missions. Just space bar right through them. Ended up getting these baleful treads, and I'm gonna send to my monk. Let's see what new ones I got. And I ended up getting 125 gold from those three. Now I'll check out my new ones. This one's 325 gold. That's just some baleful stuff. All right, so this one here, 325 gold, 91% chance. I can't really change much of it, so 325 gold. We'll start that. Let me do this here. A must-have, I would say, for this is an add-on called Garrison Mission Manager. I'll show it to you right now. Here it is right here, Garrison Mission Manager. It's an extremely good add-on. I mean, I would definitely recommend this. I'll show you exactly what it does. Bring up my followers. I have nine missions complete on this on my hunter, so I'll just tab through them. As you see, now I'm up to 500 gold for just pretty much sending my followers on missions and not even being logged in. Now I will go through my missions here to see which ones have gold, and those are always the ones that I grab first. Now what Garrison Mission Manager does is, see this little tab here? It gives you the percentage before you even have to go into the mission. Usually you go into the mission, you have no followers here, and you have to pick your follower from the side here and put them in. Not with Garrison Mission Manager. You go here, see how it says the percentages of what you're gonna get? So this one's 100 gold. This one's 50 gold, so I always 70, 32, so I always go to the top one first, which is 100. Here's the one, 100 gold. We'll hit that one. Okay, so now if you go to the one tab that says 4 times the gold, you look because you have it automatically puts the followers that can complete the mission, and then with the treasure hunter trait. So 1, 2, 3 treasure hunter traits. So that makes the gold up to 400. 8 hours, 400 gold. And you don't even have to be logged on. Just like that. So now 50, I thought I saw 70 here. Here's one for 70 gold. Hit that. You could multiply it by 3 because you have 2 followers with the treasure hunter. Whenever I get a new follower, I always try to get him as a treasure hunter. Start that. 32 gold, sorry, 50 gold. Here's 50 gold and 200 honor. 90, 100% chance times 3, or 92 times 4. I'll take the 100 times 3. It's not that big of a difference. Start that mission. And here's a 32 gold. You can double that, 65 gold. And here's a 35 gold that we could also double, 70 gold. Now I'll just scroll through the rest of them, see if there's anything I need. Always use some oil. These are really good. The rush orders for your whatever profession that building you might have in your garrison. That's it for this one. Now, that treasure hunter trait, I'm going to show you a little trick. If you have garrison rewards and you're maxed out, like I have a few of my guys that are like that. You go to Sergeant Grimjaw right out here, and for 1,000 garrison resources, follow a trait retraining guide. You grab one of those, back to your followers, and I have a few left. Let's see what they are. He's a treasure hunter already. He's a treasure hunter. See, as you can see, most of my guys are treasure hunters. So this guy is an inscription scavenger. His traits: inscription, scavenger increases the garrison resources by 100%, and a mountaineer increases success chance when fighting in the mountains. So we're going to take this follower trait retraining guide, right click it, and then go over here to click to upgrade and hit yes, and let's see, maybe we get a treasure hunter. He didn't get treasure hunter, but no big deal. You could do that a few times. You could do that over and over again as long as you have the garrison resources to buy those from Sergeant Grimjoy. You could do that until you get, keep rolling until you get treasure hunter. Okay, so this guy's finished. We had 500 gold. It could have been done a lot quicker. Alright, so let's go to the next guy and see what we get. And just send the followers out on a mission. Next thing, here's my mage. Okay, so let's see. 0 gold. Let's check the one naval mission done. 780 gold from one naval mission. Here's one here that's 850 gold. Doubled because I have a ship with a goblin crew. If you have a ship with a goblin crew, you will double the gold reward. So it's good to try and re-roll and get those goblin crew ships. 1700, 82% chance. I could actually make it better by putting a first strike and a stormy weather in here. I'll show you how to do that. You go down to your... I'm gonna add those two things. I'm gonna go try. Come down here to your naval yard, shipyard, whatever you want to call it. And you have a vendor right underneath this tent here.
I got the best
Kronk
anywhere.
Rust Spark. Alright, so what were the two things I needed to do? First Strike, which is the Fell Smoke Launcher. So I'll buy that. And the other was Chaotic Whirlpools, right? Stormy Weather, I'm sorry. Alright, Stormy Weather. So that's the Bilge Pump. So you got the Bilge Pump and that.
Keep it real.
So if it wasn't for 1700 gold, I wouldn't buy this stuff and try it out. But we'll try it out. You got your table down here still. Okay, so now we're going to hit this. Oh, sorry. Hit the tab, and it automatically puts the two ships in there. So now, we're going to find out which ships we want to put, give the Fell Smoke and the Bilge Pump to counter the First Strike and the Stormy Weather too. Okay, so this guy has a True Iron Rudder and a Blast Furnace. The True Iron Rudder... Okay, that's the Whale of the Banshee. So we go over here to the Whale of the Banshee. The True Iron Rudder counters evasive, which is this one here. So we could change the Blast Furnace out on this one. So you got Whale of the Banshee. So you take the Fell Smoke Launcher. Actually, I'm going to take the Bilge Pump and change out the Blast Furnace. And then you look back. And now I have an 88% chance because I have a check mark on Stormy Weather here. So now this guy... He has a Train Shark Tank and a Blast Furnace. I don't need either one of those for this mission, so I'll only trade one of them out to counter the First Strike. So this is Strength and Honor. So we hit him right here, hit Fleet, Strength and Honor. So we'll change that Blast Furnace to Fell Smoke Launcher. I'll go back to Naval Map, 93%. So now I have a 93% chance to get 1700 gold. So we'll definitely start that mission. No other missions right there. So now I'm gonna go back to my follower table. So now I'm at my follower table. Only three missions complete. I don't know why, only three. But I'm up to 990 gold. Got an armor enhancement here. Okay, now I'll scroll through and see what 60 gold. Which ones are for gold? 30 gold. Only two gold missions. So I hit this 60. I can triple it. Right here. Makes it 180. So I have two followers with the treasure. Hunters. Start that. Scroll down. This one's 30 gold. Hit that. I can only double the 30 gold. 60 gold. Take it. Here's another one. Now here's those rush orders. Those are always good. To finish your rush orders at your profession buildings much instantly. And then, as you can see, the garrison mission manager gives me all these things I can get done here. And it's so much easier. Just scroll through, pick the percentages that you think you'll benefit from the most, and that's it. So now he got 990 gold for just sending his followers out in a matter of minutes. And a potential to get 1700 gold on my naval mission. So I log out, and I don't know if I need to explain the rest of them. I'm just going to blow through them, and then we'll show you the totals.
Alright, so as you can see here, I made 6,900 gold, the potential to make 6,787 gold, and you can do that twice a day, really. Some missions you could do even more than that. Some missions are really short, some are long. But so you have the potential, with your followers alone, to make anywhere from 12 to 15,000 gold a day, just doing your follower missions twice a day. Like I said, you can do some three times a day. I hope you liked the video, and I hope you learned something from it. And if you did like it, hey, give me a thumbs up. Maybe subscribe, and hopefully I can get some more videos to you soon. Thanks.